Funnily enough, Chris Hoy, the British sprinter you're talking about there, switched from BMX into track cycling. Victoria Pendleton has got great support in the stands here this afternoon, and you can see her wearing the blue shorts and the white jersey. I would say cocooned in her crash helmet there, hiding all of the emotion away. She was world champion. She's the current world champion, actually, in this discipline, but she won the world championships in 2005 and 2007 as well. And she qualified for the women's sprint in an Olympic record time of 10.96 seconds for the last 200 metres. But once you get to this level of the sport, it really is very much more about the tactics than sheer speed.
Just that jockeying that you talked about, they'll start at a rather slow pace until they've worked their way around the track.
Also important to note that once you get to the final, the ride off gold and silver, it's a best of three matches. But it's a lot better to go through in two straight matches. We've seen a lot of riders take it straight through in a 2-0. And I'm sure that's what Victoria Pendleton would like to try and do if she can here. But she knows that the woman she's up against, Anna Mears, in the gold and green of Australia, is looking to try and open up the tally, because Australia have probably had their worst ever Olympic Games since 1984.
And Pendleton came into this being a women's world sprint champion, qualifying with power and poise, and now she starts to kick.
Well, Mears has got to try and get into the slipstream if she's going to come round, but you can see that Pendleton's right down at the bottom of the track, and there's not going to be any challenge at all here. She cruises to the line. It really is dominance there. 63 kilometres an hour. That was a very easy win. There's Tony Blair in the stands. You might just have noticed him with his wife, Sherry Blair, and I think they've all come down here probably with their fingers crossed to the possibility of seeing two gold medals.
The second of three matchups here in the gold and silver medal rounds of women's sprint in Victoria Pendleton. She got the nod on the first of three matchups. And Anna Mears trying to climb her way back. Had a horrible crash in January at a Kieran race, fractured her C2 vertebrae, also had neck injuries, and trying to stop this powerhouse of a team, the Brits.
Well, Anna Mears has been a world champion in the 500-meter time trial, but here she's up in the match sprint, which is three laps of the velodrome here, 250 meters per lap. The most important thing is to be the fastest over the last 200 meters and to get your bike across the line in first place. She's up against a three-time champion of the world in this discipline, wearing number 88 there. That's Victoria Pendleton, world champion in 05, 07, and 08. Outgoing champion, Laurie Ann Munzer of Canada, was one of the oldest competitors ever to win this title. The Canadian won the title at 37 years of age 4 years ago.
And when asked what she was bringing to China, Victoria Pendleton claimed, I'm bringing hair straighteners, nail polish. The color, if you're curious, Paul, is coral. Apparently, it's all the rage. And everyone knows this in track cycling, the ultimate accessory item, a gold medal.
Well, that's what she's looking for, and that's certainly what she wants to go away with here this afternoon. When you get to the gold and silver medal ride, it's the best of three. Currently, Victoria Pendleton is leading this competition 1-0 against the Australian, but be wary of the Australian because she's a very clever tactical sprinter.
And this is what we've seen from the British team, the power from early on. If Victoria Pendleton can do it, she will grab the gold. This is for the silver and gold.
Well, she's straight into the bank, and she's gone over the top there, and she's got an incredible acceleration, Victoria Pendleton. This is a cruise to the line. Another gold medal for Great Britain ahead of Anna Mears and the Union Jack, flying high again. And congratulations there for Tony and Sherry Blair, the former Prime Minister of Great Britain.
The seventh gold medal for Britain in track cycling. Incredible. And a rider who said back when she was a child that she never thought it would be possible to go to the Olympics. Not once. It was not even a consideration. And at 16, getting discovered on the track by Marshall Thomas, she finds herself, well, an Olympian gold medal winner.
Brilliant performance there. She knew at this point that she'd got herself the victory. Great Britain has invested a lot of money over the last few years for their track program. Now, just look at this, and this is how it happens. You can see Anna Mears knew that the only way to outwit the Brit was to go very fast from the front. full speed on here, but look, there's no hesitation at all from the Brit Victoria Pendleton, and coming into the last bend there, she's already got daylight between herself and the Australian. Up to the line, it's really a cruising for a bruising, really, for Victoria Pendleton, and it's a gold medal to boot.
This program has been produced by NBC.